Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Gala. Flora, congratulations. Kerry does not need introduction. He is a professional speaker and best-selling author. Okay. Non-verbal at the age of 2.5 and being diagnosed for autism at the age of 4, he had faced so many obstacles to come to this point where he is right now. Kerry is an award-winning speaker, professional national speaker, and also he's a best-selling author. I will please join me to welcome Kerry to speak a few words for this event. Thank you.
Hey guys. I was just about to say, you guys are like family now at this point. I am so honored to be here for the second year, Gift of Life USA. It's, you know, this is truly making a difference in our communities today. We need more people, like people of Gift of Life, to truly understand what impact that they can make for our special needs community. A community that a lot of the times goes underrepresented in the world today. So the reason why I'm here is a very personal story. Again, my name is Kerry Magro, I'm a professional speaker, and for the past 8 years, I've had the wonderful opportunity to collaborate with a speaker bureau called the National Speakers Association to talk about not only autism, but how we as people can become the best versions of ourselves. And to get us started tonight, I want to share with all of you a quick poem, which for people who are just meeting me for the first time, will hopefully make you understand my journey as someone who has autism. And this poem is called Only If You Knew Me. Sorry. If you knew me, you would know I was nonverbal at 2.5. You would know I was diagnosed with autism at 4. You would know that I got kicked out of 2 therapeutic preschools because they said they didn't know how to control me. You would know I had extreme sensory integration difficulties. You would know I would lash out to get attention when I couldn't communicate on my own. You would know I twirl my hair. And unfortunately, you would know that when I was in school, my peers labeled special education wrong instead of special. You would know I spent hundreds of hours a year in therapy, both in occupational, physical, speech, music, and theater therapy, to get me to the point where I am today. And unfortunately, you would know I spent hundreds of hours a year getting bullied because of my autism diagnosis and people not understanding me. And for a very, very short time early on, you would know, unfortunately enough, that being institutionalized was a possibility. But if you also knew me, you would know I graduated from college. You would know I've received a master's degree. You would know I'm currently pursuing my doctorate in education, ironically enough, to become a professor, to teach those about people with special needs. You would know I have a full-time job today as a professional speaker, traveling around the country to share about autism spectrum disorders. You would now know I live independently. You would know I consult for major motion pictures to bring a realistic portrayal of disability to our entertainment industry. You would know that I help parents who have children with disabilities, but you would also know that I'm a mentor to help those with disabilities make sure that they know that they don't have to go through this journey alone,
and that they have supports. And my mom gets a kick out of this every single time I say it, so I have to keep it in the bone. You would know I've got a girlfriend. There we go. thank you for the clap. Thank you for the applause. I appreciate that. You would know I love my family, my friends, and the community, especially the gift of life community that we have out here today. But most importantly, you would know that I'm caring. And no matter what autism means, it doesn't mean, I'm just trying to be the best me that I can be, only being here. If you're listening to this poem tonight, please know that autism can't define our loved ones, and only we can define autism. I know so many kids, both with autism and a wide range of developmental disabilities, Down syndrome, cerebral palsy, who are trying to be the very, very best that they can be, just like any one of us. We as a community have so many unique and beautiful stories. So let's please make sure that they are heard. As part of my journey on the autism spectrum, for the past 8 years, I've got to travel the country speaking at over 800 events about everything from the spectrum of autism, everything from early intervention to adulthood on the autism spectrum. And when I was talking with Laura about what I was going to talk about tonight, you know, there is such an emphasis on children with disabilities, but a lot of the times we forget about adults with disabilities. And what happens to these kids when they grow up? With your support today, we can truly make an impact in the lives of all those with disabilities, but we can also make an impact for those who age out of school at 21 and might not have the supports really needed to succeed as much as they would have in school. I've given a TEDx talk on this topic of what happens to children with autism when they become adults with autism, simply because when I was growing up, I had no transitional services. I had no services to help me. So long story short, being that kid who was completely nonverbal, who was scared of the world around him, I can now tell you today I've overcome many of my obstacles, and the only hope that I have for our community, because if you met one individual with a disability, you met just that one individual with a disability, is that we can help improve the quality of life for every single person who lives with a disability today. As part of this event, as Laura mentioned, I have written two books. We're going to be donating copies of our books to Gift of Life in the hopes of fundraising for the cause and supporting the cause here tonight. So we'll be doing that. And, you know, the most important thing I can tell any single person in this room is that this wasn't supposed to be my future. And now, mentoring over 300 kids around the world who have special needs, the quote I always leave them with, and I try to instill in them every single time I see them, is that don't let any one thing in your life define them. Go out and define your lives and your journeys in the way that you see it. And I can only hope that for every single one of you. And if you need help getting started, saying about 500 people in this room, I have 650 business cards in my place here. So let's start our conversation, and thank you all so much for having me.